Hello, Miramar. I'm Mayor Wayne Messam, and welcome to the Mayor's Corner. As residents and business owners in the city of Miramar, you should always be aware of what is taking place in your city government. There are many ways for this to happen, whether via attendance in person at our city commission meetings or viewing our meetings online, or whether or not you are plugged into our social media platforms or in our print communications that can be seen throughout the city of Miramar. It is our job as your representative to keep you informed. One announcement I would like to bring to your attention is the hiring of our new city manager, Dr. Roy Virgin. You may ask what happened to our previous city manager, and he was not retained by the city commission. A majority of the city commission members opted not to have our prior city manager go beyond his 6 months probationary period. I was not in support of that decision, but the will of the commission has moved forward, and we do welcome Dr. Roy Virgin as our new city manager, and I look forward to working with Dr. Virgin as we chart out the next phase and era of our city under new city administration. So join me in welcoming Dr. Roy Virgin as our new city manager. He will need not only the support of the commission and city staff, but more importantly, he needs your engagement as well as your ideas to help to ensure that the will of the public is maintained. In June, America celebrates Caribbean American Heritage Month, and the city of Miramar is no exception. We'll do our own twist with our free yoga Saturdays at the Miramar Cultural Centers at 10 a.m. every Saturday through June with our Caribbean American Heritage themed classes. You don't want to miss what's in store for you in these fantastic and vibrant classes led by Rocky Rowland every Saturday in June from 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. And we'll see you for Yoga Saturdays. Miramar, it's that time again. Mark your calendars and save the date as Miramar celebrates our nation's independence on July 4th. This event is the city's largest event where we have over 10,000 visitors and residents descend on Miramar Regional Park to watch our fabulous fireworks display. And this year will be no different. And we look forward to celebrating our nation's independence with you and your families. But wait, there's more. Backed by popular demand, we will have the mayor's concert just before the fireworks, so stay tuned as we announce our performers. See you there. I recently hosted a reception recognizing Haitian businesses in the community as part of Haitian Heritage Month. Our honorees were as follows: Nephthali Hyacinth, who's the owner of Tally & Co. Strategies; Princeton Jean-Claude, who owns primary medical care centers in the city of Miramar; and the law offices of Kirch Kuntz, PA. And our final awardee was La Paix Bakery, Inc. All of these businesses are located right here in the city of Miramar, and we could not be more proud of some of our Haitian American pillars that are in our community and makes Miramar such a wonderful place to work, live, and play. The city of Miramar recently hosted a Get Out the Vote rally sponsored by the Florida Black Legislators. In response to some bills that were passed by the Florida legislature, Florida Black legislators across the state held a series of Stay Woke and Get Out the Vote rallies to ensure that residents throughout the state of Florida are aware of their voting status, as well as to get them registered to vote in the upcoming primary and November general elections. The city of Miramar encourages you as Miramar residents to ensure that you are not only registered, but that you are an active participant in the upcoming general and primary elections. Regardless of who you vote for, your vote matters. So make sure that you are heard and that you know your status, but more importantly, that you show up at the polls to make your voice heard. You know, the dream of expanding cultural experiences in Broward County out west to the Sawgrass is something that Miramar has taken a leadership position in. And one example of such cultural experiences in the city of Miramar was the ability to attract the Compa Fest that took place at the Miramar Amphitheater. CompaFest is perhaps the largest Haitian-themed festival in the world, and the city of Miramar was able to attract this great international event right in the city of Miramar. Haitian Americans and fans of compa music came to the city of Miramar, danced, celebrated, and had such a great time. So these are many benefits that the city of Miramar has to offer, not just to our residents, but visitors alike. The event went on with such a success, and thousands of individuals had an opportunity to not only partake in CompaFest, but to share in with our Haitian brothers and sisters during Haitian American Heritage Month to celebrate their art form. 2 months ago, I challenged the city of Miramar, as I do every April, to participate in the Wyland Water Conservation Challenge. The city of Miramar has had its best performance yet, and I am so proud of our Miramar residents. Miramar finished third in the entire United States of America in conserving water during this Wyland's Water Conservation Contest. I could not be more proud as the mayor, as we all did our part collectively to reduce our impact in the utilization of water. So let's continue this practice throughout the year, and next year, you know what our goal will be, yes, and that is to take first place. Congratulations, Miramar, great job. Thanks for joining me on this edition of The Mayor's Corner. You know, as we reflect on the tragedy and the horror that took place in Buffalo, New York, as well as in Texas, most recently, we saw 19 children from an elementary school senselessly murdered. Our hearts go out to the community as we continue to push for change that will reduce and eliminate these types of tragic events. You know, although there has not been any direct threats to any schools in the city of Miramar, I would like to let the public know that the City of Miramar Police Department is not only being vigilant, but also present in our schools to ensure that we deter any type of horrific events and taking place in the City of Miramar. We would like to thank our police department for their vigilance, and we would like you to know, as parents in our city, that the safety of our schools through our resource officers is a priority for the city of Miramar. Until next time, I'll see you on The Mayor's Corner.